Let's start with track one, called Max Patching. Here we find the note doubler device, which is a MIDI effect. We have one dial that controls the delay time for every note that goes through the device. We can also hear the original MIDI notes and rhythm are unaffected, so the delayed note is an addition. Let's see how this is done inside the patch, by clicking the Edit button to open the device. In every device that is part of this introduction live set and the lessons live sets, there will be a number of steps we can go through to achieve a goal. The goals are described in the lessons panel of the live sets. The first step in this patch is to switch from the presentation mode to the patching mode. Now we see the actual patch that's doing the work. We'll not discuss every object that's used in this patch, and we'll instead focus on the designated steps. Of course, you are always free to explore the patch on your own, for example by Alt or Option clicking objects to learn more about them in their respective help patchers. This particular help patcher of the live dial object has two tabs that we can look at. In the second tab, we can see all the different attributes of the object that we can change the color of, as well as the general appearance of the dial. The patch also contains a delay velocity dial, which allows us to decrease or increase the velocity value for the delayed MIDI notes. This dial wasn't visible yet in the device before, and that's because we still have to add it to the presentation. Now let's go to the presentation mode and position the dials so they both fit nicely in the device. Saving the device now ensures the changes are reflected in live. And once we close the patcher, we can interact with our new dial in live.